Hello, hello, hello. Today is day 191, making Songbringer. Really excited to have this lightning done. Check out this. Oh, that was lucky. So the way the lightning works is that it hits the lightning strikes the enemy which is you know hit by your ghost ice or ghost lightning sword. And then lightning strikes again somewhere randomly on the screen, and you can get hit by your own lightning. So if it randomly strikes you, that sucks. But there you go, that just happened again where it randomly struck another enemy. It's pretty rad. Yeah, I'm really, really happy how this turned out. It's just so rad. This and the fire one are so sweet. I mean, and the ice one is really, really useful too, because the ice one is really the only thing that can freeze enemies, essentially stun enemies. So, yeah. Today I'll be working on... Yo, what's up, guys? Alex Pita, Excellence. What's up, guys? Yeah, I'm really happy how it turned out. So today I'll be making the rivers. So... I'm gonna run the overworld scene and look where this world is meant to have its rivers so we can see where it's supposed to be putting them. Then I can, you know, go to that area. Okay, so here we go. Actually, let's let it run all that so we can see the paths that this world will have too. This is lasers. The world lasers. All right, cool. So I've got that screenshot taken. I can go. Let's clean this up and leave it here in Photoshop. Yay! Right on. Excellence. Remind me what classes you're taking right now. What is it you're studying and stuff? Look at that. Here's a crazy. Yeah. Did you guys see that? Look at this. A JPEG of this would be 300K. A ping 24 would be only 22K. Pretty cool. I'm going to save this on my desktop as lasers. So I've just got that. I can work with this today. We go. Okay, so here's where the river is supposed to be. I'll put the player right here so we can do this area first. So this is 7, 8, 9, 10. So we want to be at 10, 0. And it should have some water already at this area, but well, no, it won't have it. Yeah, it won't have any kind of river or whatever. So, oh, look, there is water on this level though. I love the lightning sword. Cool. So, from that map we just saw, the river should be going right through on the left side of this screen. Think, yeah, so the left side of the screen should have a river. So, oh, network security, rad, awesome. Okay, I think the best place to put this would be where it adds water. So there's a function called add water, and this is currently based on the Perlin noise, the existing terrain, which is generated from Perlin noise based on your world seed and all that. So that creates some water, but now I'm trying to create some more specific water. Okay, so we'll just throw this in the end of this method here for now. It's probably going to be a better place because already this method is too long. So, but anyways, we'll put it here for now. So let's create some rivers. Create rivers. Let's loop over all the directions. So, or for each quadrant. Okay, so now we got a loop over each one of the quadrants. We want to check the style. Let's see if we've got the maze already in this function. No? That's weird. Oh well. Okay, so let's grab the maze. What's up, Skittle Fiddler? I'm working on rivers right now, but check out how awesome the lightning sword turned out from yesterday. So it's one of the ghost swords. You combine your ghost sword with lightning and you can get this lightning sword. And it randomly strikes, so it strikes the enemy that you hit, and then it randomly strikes another place on the screen. So there is a chance that you can get hit by your own lightning. But there's also a chance that the lightning can hit an enemy. So it's a pretty cool weapon. So yeah, loving how that turned out. So okay, we're gonna get the maze world. Get maze for area pause.z. All right. What's up, Hoo Hoo? Yo, man. Did I already get this? Oh, is it just not using it? Anyways, let's check if we have. If we don't have a river, then we'll continue the loop. So if maze.getStyle squared or xy quadrant. Yeah, let's do xy quadrant area pause dot x area pause dot y quadrant q. It's not equal to k style. Where's river? There it is. River. Okay, so we don't have a river. We're continuing. Now this is what's up, Felix? Yo, man. I'm making rivers right now, and the ice or the all of the elemental swords are done so far. So we got a fire sword. There's the lightning sword. There's the ice sword. There's the ghost sword. There's the fear sword. And I think there'll be a wind sword as well. But anyways, we're now making rivers. This whole week I'm going to be focusing on the overworld again. So this is going to be cool. Get some rivers done. Get some lakes done. And start with some more art styles too. So there's only one art style. And I can't wait to do more art styles. I want to do a light style jungle, a dark style jungle, and a more mountainous area, and also maybe some desert / sea. Thanks, man. Okay, so let's do this with the river. Let's just go ahead and loop over X and Y and create a river without any bridges. So bridges are also going to be, you know, totally necessary, but we'll start without bridges because it's simpler. Atari, the amazing. Sorry, man. Yeah, I know. I do usually get it started a lot earlier. In fact, I don't know how the heck Alex Peter is even awake right now. But yeah, so what time is it? 5:45. Sorry about that. I usually get started earlier, but today's been kind of one of those days where I couldn't get started early. Oh, a heat-seeking sword? Ooh, that's a good idea. Alex Pita, once again, coming in with the rad idea. Heat seeking, sword, or maybe another item that would do that. Give you like a heat seeking projectile. I like that. Hey, what's up, Avoxin? Oh, it's only 12:45 there in Iceland? Wow, nice. I thought it was like 3 o'clock or something in Italy by now. What's up, Zatrick? Welcome, you guys. Right now I'm making some rivers, and the lightning sword's done too, so you'll be seeing that. I'm using that right now. Yeah, just answered that. Making river right now. So check this out. This is the world generator. I worked on this a couple weeks ago. This is the new world generator. And this is the area that I'm working on right now. I'm in this particular area right here. And I'm working on this river. This blue line that's coming through this half of these screens right here is going to be a river. So I'm just creating the code right now to implement that river. Ah. A typhoon sword? Whoa. I think I definitely want a wind sword too. In fact, I want to put that on there. Wind sword. A wind sword that knocks back enemies. It'd be kind of like a typhoon sword. Hey, yo, what's up, Doc? Howdy. Okay, so I'm so tempted to just do this a really janky way at first. I'm gonna just do this. So for y equals 0, y is less than height. Oh, that's the same. X equals something like half the width. Minus 3. And then x is less than half the width. Oh, this is supposed to be times over 2. There. Yeah, I'm doing great, man. Yeah. Sorry I'm getting started so late. I know it's really late for a lot of you guys. But, yeah, at least I got started. So I'm working on this river right here, this little blue line right there. I'm trying to turn that into an actual river. Fast forward sword? Well, that's a crazy idea. I think that could also be another item. Let me add that to the ideas too. Like a... I don't know how to word that one. Maybe it would be like it would be such a powerful item that maybe you can only use it once or something. Item which rapidly ages enemies, turning them into skeletons. Skeletons. Okay, so here's the janky part. This shouldn't be so specific, right? It's the ancient. It's an ancient artifact. This'll do. This will actually work, though, I think. So we want to set the current tile to X, Y, to K, tile, water. Oh, summoning sword? So, that could be an item as well, like a different item. It wouldn't actually be a sword item, but it would be interesting to do that. And you could also have, as well as the summoning, you could have something which, it woos enemies over to your side, so you get like little enemies to fight for you. Those are kind of the same item, but a little different. Okay, cool. We've got a river. There's nothing connecting the river though. So yeah, anyway, it's just joined the stream. Here's what the lightning sword looks like. The lightning sword. It strikes the enemy and then it strikes one random place on the screen. So you have a chance to maybe accidentally hit another enemy. But you can also be hit yourself by the lightning, so you can get hurt with your own lightning. Okay, so we've trapped the player on the screen. Let's turn it into God mode really quick so I can run around and just see if that worked to create this river. So we've got the water there. And put it underneath the refill. Okay, for some reason it covered it up here. But yeah, in general, this river worked. Yeah, totally. Yeah, totally. That's what this one is. Some kind of item. Let's call it the blob staff for now. The blob staff idea. Okay, all right. I'm trying to get my brain into gear today. It's kind of been one of those days. So that's why all this is kind of still trying to get into gear with it. So let's see what I can get done, because I really don't know how long I'll be able to stream or how much I'm gonna be able to get done today, but it would be cool to be able to finish these rivers really well, but I'm not sure if I will. Yeah, global bomb, totally. I was thinking that would be a great item for debugging as well. So, like, if you have a couple of these global bombs, yeah, totally. So if you have some of those, it'd be really easy to like kill all the enemies. Nuke item. Chip gets a sword. I think there already is an idea on here where Jib gets a tiny little like laser. It's kind of the same thing, he gets a but he won't do as much damage. Where is that? I think it's on here already. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's an item already, or an idea already. Is call it the sharp stash? Where is that Jib? Maybe not. Maybe that's just not on there yet. Yeah, totally. The expansion board, that's right here. Jib expansion boards. Already got that one on there. You must have mentioned that earlier. Yeah. Hi, I'm a unicorn. Wow, dude, you're the first unicorn I've ever met. You're the ultimate unicorn? What's up, lag script? You're popcorn? This is great. I don't need to do any work today. We can just laugh all day. How's that sound? No, I gotta at least try and finish this river algorithm. You're a corny salesman. Okay, I think what I would do is this. If this is open path X, Y, include interior true. Continue. Okay, so let's see if that worked to give a path across the river. So it does look like it did there. Here it puts on there. Yeah, this just kind of broke the whole river. Yeah, I don't know if I like it. I'm not sure that I like this whole. Oh man. I started doing this and now I don't want to do it anymore right now. Can you have a hug? Can you use CocoaCityX on Windows? Yes, you can, the lag script. Yep, I was just gonna recommend that. Yep, I wrote a tutorial on CocoaCityX. I highly recommend using Rapid Game. Let me post you a link to that. Rapid Game, you can download it on Windows as well. It's a tool I wrote which pre-compiles CocoaCityX, so you never have to compile it twice. Does it show how to make a game from scratch? Not entirely, no. You have to kind of put that. My tutorial shows how you would. It's not that integrated, right? It's like. It lets you fill in the dots, right? After every chapter of the tutorial, there's like an entire book there. And after every chapter is done, it's sort of like dot, dot, dot. Like you have to figure it out yourself. So, no, it's not like a hold your hand style tutorial. There's probably better ones out there. Okay, well, you know what? I was saying this should be part of a different function anyways. Like it should be more, because we're already getting to be like. Let's add rivers. Let's make a whole separate method for this. Actually, I'm just gonna call it add river, because this is a single area we're talking about. So we're gonna add river as well. Let's go separate this out into a different method. I'm gonna comment that out for now. Yeah, so when the world creates each Z level of the game, here it is, blending, create maze Z, this is it. Okay, so it goes area, da 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 da, da all this stuff. That's weird, I would have expected to see add water somewhere around here. Anyways, let's add it manually. We'll go add river. There. Okay, so this should overcome the fact that one of those screens had some. Some tiles at the top of it that weren't water. They should have been. Okay, so we've got this river here. Here it is. Yeah, cool. Okay, so here's exactly where it was that it had some bushes. So good, now that works. And this is where the river is going to end. This is actually the screen where it's all going to turn into a lake. Yeah, the rivers are going to be straight lines to start with, at least. Yeah, just to keep it simple, straight lines, not winding, very Zelda 1-esque. What's up, professional novice? What's Gucci? What you mean? You trying to say what's good? It's good, my man. Yeah, thanks, man. I love how the lightning turned out too. The fire one is too is really rad too. Oh yeah, there you go. Cool. I thought so. I'm getting good at translating. I see these weird words I don't understand, and I guess sometimes my guesses are right. Yay for me. Okay, we need some kind of flag. It shows that an area has a river. Yeah, let's do that. Or a lake. Yeah. Okay, let's do that. We'll do K flag river and K flag lake. Oh, we also need a K flag waterfall. Yep. So we'll go. Actually, let's just call it K flag water feature. Nah. Yeah, we'll just do K flag river. Option section? For what? For you mean for the whole game? It's already got one. Here we go. We got river, lake, waterfall. So this will allow the world generator to put these flags when it's using these kind of styles in an area. So that it doesn't also place a flag for like a refill or a level entrance or any of that kind of stuff. You know what? I'm gonna add another method too to this header. We've got add river. Let's go add lake as well. Because I know I'm gonna need that in a second. Okay, so when we're generating the maze, for water option? I'm confused. I'm not sure what you mean there. Oh, I guess we would need the C as well. Or that one could be lake. I think this is gonna work. So X2 shifted down one, Y2 shifted down one. We want K flag river, and we need another. Oh yeah, I guess C could be lake as well. Let's just not worry about that. Nah, I think this might be necessary to have a flag C as well. We'll see. If lightning hits the river, will it kill all enemies instantly? Well, I guess it should if they're in the water. That's a good point, right? Okay, I think that will give it the flag river for that south flowing one. And hopefully that will prevent the rest of the world generator from placing anything special on a screen which has a river. I'll add that to the ideas. Nice one. Cool, I'll add that to the ideas too. If it strikes a tree, the tree falls. The tree falls an enemy, kills the enemy. Okay, so I should be running the overworld scene. Let's see if it creates. Oh, that's not even gonna show it. Or a rock shatters? Yeah, I can't wait. I wanna have rocks be able to shatter from your sword as well. Sweet, Zatrick, were you talking about that maze generator? Okay, so did it work? Let's see, this is home 8, 9, 10. No, it still put the refill there. Damn. Okay, let's see why it did that. Creates a dead end, ensure the maze is closed, special case shapes. I think it's gonna be generate overworld post. Yeah, I did, man. It took a whole week, but yeah, I did that. I did it on the stream. It's look for overworld generator. Just look for the word overworld on my YouTube channel. It's on there. Yeah. So we need to look. Oh, for every quadrant. has flags, has water. I'm not sure how to do this right now. I guess we'll try has water first.
What's up, baby? Just one room.
Once again, it's a hot day in California. And man, dude, we had an earthquake this morning. We had a 4.0 earthquake here this morning. Freaking crazy. Yeah, lag script, you can. You can. That's my channel, right? Yeah. Check it out. Lag script right here. Making Songbringer. Here's this. This is from, you can go all the way back to day one. There it is. Okay, so, yeah, we'll call it has water for now. If this gets style X, Y quadrant. Oh, we actually need to grab the style. The Songbringer Nomicon. That's what it is. 190 days of videos so far. This is the 191st. But every single day that I developed, well, not every single one. There were a few days which I didn't stream and I did doing development, but. Okay, if style equals K, style river, or style equals K, style. C or style equals K style waterfall or let's do the lake back here. K style lake has water equals true. There. I guess we could do a bool has flags too, but I'm not gonna use it just yet. So if number of openings equals one and we don't have water, then it can be considered a dead end and considered for refills and level entrances. So I didn't actually end up using those flags I just created, but let's see if this works so that it doesn't put the refill there. Thanks, man. Yeah, I know, right? It didn't cause too much trouble. But yeah, it was the Hayward fault, not the San Andreas fault. That was kind of surprised me. I didn't know there were two faults right by each other here, but there are. And the last one on the Hayward fault was actually in 1868 or something like that. So pretty crazy though. It was like jarring enough. I was in bed. It was like 7 a.m. and man, it totally woke me up and got my adrenaline really going. So crazy. This is a crazy way to get woken up. It was like a giant was outside her house shaking the house. It's crazy. Okay, so if this works, then we'll have no refill area. Right. Oh yeah, it worked. I think. Yeah. Yep. There's two big cracks here near San Francisco. Okay, it didn't put, yeah, I did. I was like, oh no. The first thing I did was like call out to my girl. I'm like, baby, are you okay? But we were totally okay. There's nothing wrong with us. Nothing wrong with our place. Nothing really happened, but it was quite frightening, I'll tell you that. Okay, so check, it should still leave that area right there. Oh, it put a secret there? But yeah, no, this area right here should still be a level entrance, or at least considered for a level entrance. Where did it put, maybe it just didn't because it found some other levels that were more interesting. Yeah, so we had four remaining dead ends. Let's loop and show those. I know, yeah. That's going to be kind of scary. If Tool is correct, the band Tool, then all of Southern California will fall into the sea. Okay, so I'm going to do a little debug output to show the remaining dead ends that weren't used so that I can see if it could have actually placed a level entrance there. It just didn't because it placed it somewhere else because of the refills were somewhere else that time. Because these are like prime locations for a level. That one and this one. No, not that one. This one and that one. These like should be levels. Yeah, that movie, yep. No, wait, no, I don't know. I didn't see the movie, so I don't know if it was actually about it falling all the way into the ocean, but. Okay, so this little bit of debug output should help clarify the whole situation here. And I guess it would also be prudent to just set a breakpoint here, because I'm not sure whether that output will actually work. I'm not sure whether I got the count right and the dead ends outsize and all that. Right. Yeah, our plan's changing right before our very eyes. Let's run this one more time. All right, so it says we have four remaining dead ends, 07, 00, 07. How could it have 07 twice? It's up on the Y. I get you. Take Alaska. How did it get the same one twice? Oh, man. Oh, you know what? What's up, Defend? It might have had the same one twice because it filled in. Yeah, 07 is just already yellow. Okay. Yeah, so here, this adds the four corners. So we should set, we should do a find.
Can you hear me watch that?
Yeah. We would have to put an op equals on this sorted vec. That'd be fine. We could do op equals. Operator equals. I don't know. What's up, Momir? Momir, it's a fan. Hey, I want to show you guys the new lightning sword from yesterday. I'm working on rivers, but, oops, hold on. So, I'm in God mode right now because I'm working on the overworld again, but, here's the lightning sword. It strikes the enemy that you hit, but it also strikes randomly somewhere else on the screen, so you can... And you can also be hit by it, so you can pot. There's a small chance that you can hit yourself with your own lightning. So, but I like how it turned out. It leaves all these cool like marks on the ground. The operator method, it gives your class the ability. So, what I'm doing here is I'm creating an operator. So that I can compare these two classes. So if I have two of these objects, I'll show you in a second a little more detailed. Let me write this first. I'm pretty sure that vec2 has an op equals. I gotta check if that has an op equals too. Hello, operator. Bup, 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 bup. Yeah, okay, it's got an operator equals. Great. Yeah. Okay, so it's compiling, but let me show you what an operator equals essentially does. So I have this custom class, right? It's called Sorted Vec2. This is an object with just a position and a distance inside it. So if I had two of those, like I say I had Sorted Vec2, V1, and I had V2, right? And I had filled those up with some values and stuff like that. I could go like this. If V1 equals V2, then do something, right? So what this equal equals is actually calling is that operator equals method I just created. See what I mean? All the operators do is allow you to use regular C++ semantics to call methods on your class. Do you get it, LagScript? I hope that makes sense. It's just a simple way of kind of extending your classes. So now we should be able to go auto it equals dead ends dot find. No, that's not that. It's find dead ends dot begin dead ends dot end. We're looking for the value p. So if it is not equal to dead ends dot a, no, if it equals dead ends dot end, then we can push back a new one. So I should be, I can verify that. Yeah, I know what you mean. So the thing is, maybe you don't understand it right now, but I would recommend doing one yourself, right? Go do a simple tutorial or challenge yourself with some kind of task to write your own. And then that will teach you a lot better than I can, because I know what you mean. When you're in the state of mind where you just kind of don't really get something, it probably means that you don't fully understand it yourself. It's like, maybe nothing we can do is going to help you understand that, but maybe the best thing is for you to just do it yourself. You know what I mean? Write something that's going to teach you that. Yeah, exactly. It's a function, right? You can do it this way too, like Momir says. It's true. Where did I learn to program? From books. I learned to program 20 years ago, and the book that I learned from was called See for Yourself, and it no longer exists. I have not been able to find it anywhere online. So, but anyways, there's lots of great books on learning C out there. And then, so I learned C, and then I learned C++ later on. And at first, I really didn't get C++. It was very hard for me to understand. And also, C was actually pretty hard to understand at first, too. I was like, I don't understand memory. I don't understand addresses. And then finally, it just all made sense. And same thing with C++. It finally just all made sense. And I did a lot of coding, so it's probably what helped. It was just I coded a lot. So, highly recommend coding a lot. And doing things that are fun, too. Oh. Did I compare it using... Oh, I did. So I can just do this. Sorted back to p... 0.0. Have I learned Java too? No, I have not. Yeah. That's one that I just haven't ever needed, haven't really ever wanted. I love C++. And the thing I kind of dislike Java in a way a little bit myself. But you know, that's my own thing. Everybody has their own language they like or they dislike, and I kind of dislike Java and I dislike C# myself a little bit, but that's just because I'm very comfortable with C++ already. So it's maybe more, not really like a dislike, it's more like I'm so comfortable with what I already know, and actually it's a pretty rad language to know because it's so portable and it's so fast. Okay, so if this worked, then this should not have, oh damn it, it didn't work. No, wait, yeah, no, it did. No, 0, 0, 15, 0. Oh, I think it works. Nice, really? That would be so dope, Momir. ASCII-R MOBA? Oh. Dude, Momir, have you seen some of the rad ASCII art that people are making today? There's some super duper rad ASCII art that's all dynamic, and like people are doing roguelike games that look awesome with ASCII art. Did I go to college? Yes, I went to college, but I had already written video games before I went to college, so I didn't feel like I was learning very much. And there were no girls in my school. No, literally, there was like 80% men at my school or something like that. So I dropped out of college and never finished. Well, hey, what's up, Proton? You got your Blitz Max. What's Blitz Max? Oh. Oh, cool. Nice. Right on, man. Oh, yeah. Cottage, what's up, man? Yeah, doing things that are fun. That's the hardest part for you. You're still a beginner and you hate all the make a string, print backwards, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I know what you mean. And you have a hard time making your own ideas? Well, what is it that you want to do? Do you want to make a game or do you want to do something else or what? Now, I would maybe do some soul searching for a little bit and then find out what it is you really want to do and then do the things that excite you after you've found that out. What's up, PMC? Yeah, totally. Android is, it's important to know Java if you're doing Android, but you can still use C++ for Android development too. So, but it is a little bit tricky in how you got to get it set up to use your C++ and your Java. So, but that's what's so beautiful about Cocos 2DX is it does the Java part for you. So you can develop my whole game in C++ and publish to Android or iOS or Mac or Windows or Linux or whatever. Yeah, I think that's what I was talking about. Cogmind, is that one of them? Yeah. But I've seen some like dynamic lighting even that's done with ASCII. Hey, Crawl. Nice. Crawl's a rad game. Definitely has inspired me artistically a lot. Cogmind. Oh, yeah. I think you showed me this one. Yeah, Cogmind. This is one of the dopest ones out there for sure. Yeah. Look at this. That's what I was thinking when you said Momir, when you said Oh man, Proton, the game's going great, man. I'm working on some rivers right now, but let me see if I can show you the lightning sword that got done yesterday. Oh man, come on. No breakpoints. No breakpoints. No whammies. So I'm in God mode right now because I'm working on this overworld, but let me show you the lightning sword. It's hard to hit enemies when you can walk really fast. So the lightning sword is a really cool one because it strikes the ground where it hits the enemy, and then it strikes the ground again somewhere randomly. So there is actually a chance that you can get hit by your own lightning sword. So that kind of makes it a little more fair, you know? Oh, man. Oh, yeah. Too tedious, huh? Well, maybe you should do something, an engine that's a little less tedious, like Game Maker or Unity. Yeah, I definitely agree in using a cross-platform game engine, for sure. That's why I use Cocos 2DX, cross-platform all the way. But you can't do art? Well, if you have any kind of desire to do art yourself, you can figure it out. I believed I couldn't do my own art for a long time. In fact, for the last whole, pretty much 20 years, all I was a programmer and a musician. And for 10 of those years, I wasn't even a musician. I was just a programmer. And when I was just a programmer and I was just getting started out in game development, I fully believed I would never be able to do music. And I proved myself wrong at one point. And then I also fully believed I would never be able to do art. Like I would always just be a programmer. So I would encourage you, if you have any of those tendencies right now, don't be so closed-minded. You might actually find out you love to do art and you love to do music and you love to make your own games. So just believe in yourself. That's what I'm trying to say. Nice. Yeah, Momir. Cool, man. Right on. So why don't you know where to start? What is it? I would say if you don't know where to start with game, if you want to do games and you don't know where to start, You need to do some tutorials, right? It sounds to me like you're at the point where you're not quite familiar enough with game development that you just don't know where to start. So what I would recommend doing is some game development tutorials. So first of all, find a game engine you want to use, right? Go try out Game Maker, try out Unity, try out these other kind of things.
Okay, I'm gonna go walk and eat beans, and we're gonna go
Okay.
walk. Are you gonna be here when I get back? So I'm not
Yeah.
gonna take my
Yeah.
keys. Okay, cool.
All right, see you, babe. So yeah, Cottage, man. Anyways, try out some game engines, find one you like, and then do some tutorials on it that are games that you would want to make, right? Sort of like what you would want to make. You're not going to find a tutorial for exactly what kind of game you want to make, but you would kind of find one in that same genre, probably. So, yeah, that's my recommendation. Once you get familiar enough with game development, then you're going to know where to start. It's not that hard, but there is a lot to know, so you just really got to get familiar with it. Proton, no, there's no shader at all for the lightning. What you see is a flash on the screen that uses additive lighting. So it uses a pure white color that's partially transparent and uses additive lighting, and that's what gives it that effect that it kind of looks like a shader. Nice. Nice, man. Yeah, totally. This is a great one. Yeah, I did this one. I did this tutorial a second ago. Yeah, there's that one. There's one I wrote kind of too. It's not really particularly about pixel art, but it's more about in general how to become an artist when you feel like you can't. You know, here's that. Yeah, listen to a clone geek. He's got some good advice here. Just make something and don't worry about your design. It sounds like you might be getting hung up on just mental issues. Just get you need to, you maybe need to see to get past it. Yeah, following a tutorial, using a tutorial. Yeah. Yes, exactly. Yeah. When you're first getting started out, it can be intimidating because there's so much to learn. I compare it to like learning to fly a plane. When you learn to fly a plane, there is so many things to learn and do right. But once you get used to it a little bit, it gets easier and easier. Same thing with driving a car. So that's a better example. Driving a car, when you first are driving especially a clutch car, a car that has a manual transmission, it takes a long time to get used to it. But then once you're used to driving a car, it's easy. It's like driving a car, riding a bicycle, or whatever like that. Atari, how long does it take me to learn C++? Actually, I learned C++ over the course of about 4 years. I wrote my first game in C, pure C, and I learned C in about 6 months. I highly recommend doing it that way. If you want to learn C++, I would recommend learning C first, and then move on to C++. Okay, so if I comment this out. I'm gonna see how many. How many dead ends we get this time. Yeah, the lag script. Yeah. I would recommend this, man. If you're having trouble starting out code, I would highly recommend. Yeah, you know, I definitely would not stream your stuff. If you're having trouble just even typing out code, then you're not ready to be streaming. What I would recommend you do is don't even code. Start out with Game Maker or Unity, it's just game software. And do some tutorials on with Game Maker or Unity or whatever. until you feel like you're more confident with your code. You know what I mean? Because once you'll learn GameMaker a little bit, you'll learn like Unity a little bit, and you're learning the overall process of making games more than just learning how to code. Learning how to code is only a small part of making games. I guess I shouldn't say small part, but it's only one part of making games. So if it's a stumbling block for you at first, don't even try it. Don't even worry about it, man. Yeah, so why do you want to switch to C++? If it gets you fiddly doo-dah. I know what you mean, though. C++ is kind of a fiddly doo-dah type of language. You really can do anything with it. So that's why I would almost write a whole game in Unity first. And before you ever want to learn C++. It sounds like you might have... Well, I don't know. I can't help you then, man. I don't know. You're going to have to make up your own mind. Okay. Let's see. If I commented that out. Seven. Okay, so we have seven. Yeah, there's 12 different sorted vectors here. One of them is 15, 0. Another one is 0, 7, and 0, 7, and 0, 0. So 12. And now if I do this again without that code... or with this extra code, which prevents it from duplicating anything that's already in there. Yeah, that's what I was trying to say there, yeah. Thanks, Clone Geek. Yeah, cool. So it didn't put in two of those. So it added on 15.0 and 0.0, but it didn't duplicate 0.7, which had already been in the list. Okay, cool. Okay, I trust that a little bit more now. Now that that's a little bit better, it doesn't duplicate things. Yeah. Yes, right. Yeah. Thanks, you guys. Thanks for helping me. I feel like I don't quite have the words to explain what I'm trying to say today. Yeah. Okay, so let's see what happens when we turn off this breakpoint completely now. Run it again. It should show us. Let's see, this area straight all the way up from here. Okay, it's still blank, but did it consider it? It should have considered that one a dead end. That one. And that one. So we've got dungeon entrance. No, it didn't. Ugh. Yeah, I don't know, LagScript, I'm not sure if I agree with you there. I don't think you should be doing anything. I think the word should is a flag that you should use to recognize that you're trying to limit yourself in a way. You know what I mean? When I started learning to paint, for example, I used other people's images because I had no clue how to paint stuff. And so I would actually like I don't have a good example in this actual room, but painting for me, I had to use other people's images to start with because I had no idea how to do shading and stuff like that. So I don't think you should have a problem with imitating other people's code at first. Yeah, don't worry about it, man. You gotta kind of imitate things at first, and then once you have imitated enough, you've learned enough of how games are developed, then you can create things out of your own imagination because you know how to do it. For me, I feel like I'm finally getting to that point with my paintings. Like, I can actually create things from my mind, but it's taken me 4 years now of painting for me to get to that point. So I just wouldn't worry about it. Don't try and force yourself to do things a certain way. And the word should is a trigger that shows you that you're thinking that way. So if you ever find yourself saying, I should do this or I should do that, question that. Question that whole mentality. Yeah. Okay, this is so crazy. What did I do to mess things up? I'm lost in my own code today. Here, if I comment this out. Oh, no, that's not the problem. I don't think that's the problem. Let's see. Yeah, okay, that's not the problem. It's the problem was that with the water. Where the heck was that? Where the heck was this has water? There it is. Yeah, it was right above it. Okay, so if I disable has water, it looks like I might be putting some water on top of, or in the, yeah, I think that's what it is. Yeah, okay. It looks like that screen right there has the lake style. So let me comment this back out right here, and where it goes and it actually places the lakes. You know what, I don't need this code anymore at the end. This was kind of the old way of doing it. Oh, here it is. Okay, lakes. Lakes. Where does it add the lake style? Add lakes. Here we go. Common Sensey, what's up, man? Yeah, it's probably just the lighting, man. Ah, okay, yeah. That line right there, that's what was creating the style lake. Right in the middle of the lake. So if I comment that out and I leave that other one as it was, it should be able to put a a level right there in the middle of this lake. Yes. Oh, that's good to see again. Okay, that's what it was. So yeah, we've got a refill there. We've got a level one here. Should be able to have another one too. Yeah, I wrote a shader for myself. No, it's probably just the lighting. It's just that I'm sitting in a closet here doing my code, and there's backlight, so that's why it takes my face and makes it dark sometimes. But I'm not actually that dark. I'm a white man. Okay, good enough for now. So yeah, then now, okay, all I was doing there was making it so it didn't put the refill on top of the river. But it works. So I can take away this one bit of code. Where was that? Here. So here we're gonna count openings. Here we detect water. Here. We're pushing a new dead end. And here. Consider omitting this point if it has flags or forcing this point if it has level entrance flag. Something like that. What's up, Xbox Taco? It wasn't me. Okay, one thing, I did all that, and now I don't even need to do this. K-flag, C, waterfall, lake, river, all those are kind of unnecessary now. So I'm gonna recompile this code, I'm gonna run it. Xbox Taco, check this out, man. This is the lightning sword from yesterday. Somebody selling donuts out in the street? Maybe they're freshly made. Yeah, so Taco, here's the new lightning sword. I think you were here for the end of the stream yesterday or something. So when you hit an enemy with the lightning sword, it strikes in not only where you hit the enemy, man, it's so hard to use it because I'm in God mode right now. But anyways, you saw what it was doing. It strikes the ground where it hits the enemy, and then it also strikes another random place on the screen, which could hit you, actually, too, so. All right, so I'm gonna take a quick break, fill up my water, be right back. How many lines of script are there in Songbringer? Zero. There's no scripts. Where'd he go? I disappeared. I'm back. I'm gone. And I'm back. What's up, Speedy Flip? Okay, so I think what I should do next is make it so these rivers are a little, they're drawn a little bit better. So right now I did this janky algorithm. Let's do the algorithm a little bit better. I think that'll help the non-horizontal. How did that get there all of a sudden? Yeah, so there should be another river. Yeah, I think this river right here should be horizontal, but it's putting it vertical the whole time. So we start drawing these rivers better, with a better algorithm here. Yo, it's the best game ever, right, Peekaboo? Oh, I love Peekaboo. So we could do Y max, X max. Can you have a canoe? I was thinking of just doing bridges, but maybe a canoe would be a cool item. So we can just do a switch on the quadrant. I guess there might be a better way to do this, but I'm not aware of one right now. Case K, start with southeast, just break. Yeah, like the ladder. Sail the oceans. Oh, no worries, did you mean code? If you meant code, then yeah, there's. I can give you a count on the code. There's make. Is that it? Yeah, there's 31,000 lines of code in Songbringer, and if anything, I want this to get reduced at some point. Like I think I can get rid of maybe 5,000 lines of code or something like that, just making things more data driven. Or freezing the river with the ice sword. Now that is a cool idea. That reminds me of. Crystallis for the NES. Yeah, that's the ideas list. Okay, so the southeast quadrant. No, what quadrant are we? Let's start with the southwest quadrant. North, west, northeast. So southwest is going to be x equals this. X max equals width over 2. Y equals 0. Y max equals height over 2. I guess you can if you want to. I think it looks worse. Because every line of code you write is a time debt. Whoops. One day you'll have to go back to that line of code and fix it. Possibly. Exactly. All right, there. So we got southwest, let's do northwest. Oh, this is where the trick comes in though. See, because we could have southwest, but the direction. Direction could be vertical. Yeah, so the direction of the river can go north, south, or east, west. And either way, there's all different quadrants to go. So I guess I could do, if vertical, do a different switch. If horizontal, do another switch. But I know there's some wicked awesome way I could make it so I wouldn't even have to do that. But wait a minute. And I guess, I was thinking of rivers that could possibly bend in a corner there. Maybe like a river could actually, but that would just be more confusing. And already I've kept it simple by doing straight lines for these rivers. Yeah, that's the idea. I don't know. I might implement that idea. I might not. I don't know. I feel like this is going to get ugly this way, but oh well. So we could do this, like bool horizontal equals false, or like this, if it equals maze.getStyle. Yeah, let's do this on a couple separate lines. So if maze.getStyle k southwest and oh, equals K style river and northwest is river, then horizontal equals still false. Oh, no, yeah, it's false. So if southwest and southeast, then it's horizontal. Else, if northwest and northeast, then horizontal equals true. So now we can do these crazy switches like this. If horizontal, do a separate switch, then vertical. Okay, southeast starts at x equals width over 2. These are both, oh, these are horizontal. I'm thinking of vertical first. Okay, vertical river. southeast equals x equals width over 2, x max equals x plus 3. Actually, that one's also x plus 3. And same y. All right. Northwest is a lot like southwest, only the y is different. So the y starts at height over 2 and goes to height. And northeast is, oh wait, no. Wait, so northwest? Yeah, northwest, that's what northwest is. Northeast is a lot like southeast. So let's put northeast and southeast right next to each other just to indicate that a little bit more clearly. X northeast, x is width over 2, x max, x plus 3, y equals height over 2, y max equals height. Okay, I'm seeing a better way to write this, which is a little less coupling. So see how I'm duplicating that, I'm duplicating this, and that, and that. Well, I'm duplicating things a lot here. So if the quadrant is southeast or southeast or northeast, has the same x's. Quadrant k southwest or quadrant equals k northwest, same x's. Now, if we've got southeast or southwest or southeast, then it's y equals this over that. And if it's northwest or northeast, then it's this. So there, now we're not duplicating any code at the expense of doing a few more of these ORs. What's up, Ethan? All right, there. We have a vertical river. Let's see if it works. Oh, it didn't work. Oh, lame. Southwest, southeast, northwest, northeast. Okay, we'll figure out what's up. I'm gonna set a breakpoint this way. I'm not using it. I could use a conditional breakpoint here, but I found out these are really slow if you call it a lot, and this is a method that does get called a lot. Well, actually, no. I guess it's not that bad. Yeah, let's try a conditional breakpoint. So we want if area pause dot x equals what area is this? 10, 7, 8, 9, 10. And area pause dot y equals 0 and break. Okay, so we'll see what's going on inside this method step by step, inch by inch. Okay, so this should be giving me, should be horizontal, staying at false. Okay, good, it did. Now, we're in quadrant southeast. Didn't have a river, that's great. Quadrant southwest, should have a river, and it does. Great. We got if horizontal, okay. Now, quadrant southwest. These should both be else's right here. Whoops. In fact, we don't even need this. There, that's more simple. Yeah, southeast, northeast, southwest, southeast. Yeah. Okay, so what does it end up doing? Yeah, x is width over 2 minus 3, x max. All right, we got x of 7, x max of 10, y of 0, y max of 10. That should be fine. Oh, there it is. Okay, duh. I wrote these loops wrong. If anybody was just paying attention, you would have seen it too. I need to reset y each time. So we need an x start. Okay, I expect it to work this time. Yeah, nice, we finally have the river again. Okay, we've got a nice vertical river going all the way up to here. Good, and that's where it should end because this is where it should have an actual lake. Okay, let's do the horizontal rivers as well. They're going to be similar to this algorithm, but a little different. So, horizontal rivers, we want to start by testing. Yeah, they're the same tests. It's just they have different values. So southeast or northeast starts at width over 2 and goes to width. And then, so this would be southwest or northwest would be starting at 0 and going to width over 2. And then same thing with these vertical ones, same tests. Quadrant is southwest or southeast. The y-min is width over 2 minus 3. The y-max is the y-min plus 3. And I should do a const for how wide these rivers are anyways. So const int river width equals 3. And okay, if we're northwest or northeast, then we start at, oh no, this is height. Height over 2, yeah. And then this is height over 2. Y max. Northwest, northeast. It's just Y max equals Y min plus river width. Here's river width again. River width. River width. Okay. All right, so this is about it for today's stream. I'm gonna go check if this works by just going looking at the vertical river and checking that it still works, and then looking at the horizontal river and checking if that one works. Yeah, cool. So this vertical river is still looking good. And it goes the whole distance up to where there should be a lake, but that'll be the next thing. Now, where is this horizontal river supposed to be at? Let's see. There's supposed to be a horizontal river starting here. This is 11, right? 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4. 11, 4. Yeah, you guys too, have a great night. I'm just about to close it up here. I'm just gonna make sure this horizontal river works before I go. So it looks like it did do, oh, there. Yeah, here it is. Cool, so it went all the way over here to this screen. Good, all right, so we've got a horizontal river, we've got a vertical river, lightning sword. Ooh, just missed that guy. Oh, just missed him again. You guys are crazy. All right, you guys. So, yeah, that's it for today's stream. It's just been mostly a code day because I'm trying to get these new rivers to work. And I'll be getting lakes to work probably tonight, too. Let's see. Maybe. I need to get bridges, too, to be working because on this screen there should be a bridge probably connecting. And it depends on the paths of an area, but pretty much I need to be able to have bridges on any kind of river. So I'll figure that out too. Bridges will be the next thing I work on. So yeah. All right, so yeah, we'll see you guys next time. If you guys just joined the stream, if anybody just joined, this game's called Songbringer. You can pre-order it if you like. It's a Zelda It's like a game like Zelda 1. It's procedurally generated. You can pre-order it at songbringer.com. And I stream every day just about, usually in the afternoon. So that's it. We catch you guys next time.